Hey guys, what's going on? In this video, we're going to show you how to replace the front rotors on a 2015 Kia Sportage.
We're doing front brake pads and rotors on it, and we're going to remove the caliper bolt, which is a 14 millimeter first. We'll get these two off, and then we'll get the 17 millimeter off that holds the bracket on for the brake pads. And just like the rears, they have two locking Phillips bolts that hold the rotors on, and we're gonna have to take those off with the impact driver and get those right off. And you don't want to strip them out and then have to drill them, pain in the butt. So I'll show you the impact driver that we use. Get at the local Java. It's fairly inexpensive, 20 bucks I think, and it's probably a good thing to have around in the shop. So we're gonna roll the caliper back a little bit, but and we can stick our bar in here and try and get the piston to collapse for us. Looks like it's stuck onto the brake pad a little bit. Yeah, it is. See if we can get maybe as small as, there we go. All right, so we're going in between the caliper and the piston, the rotor and the piston, and just trying to collapse that. And you can see it pushed it back, and we should be able to get this caliper off now. And you can see the piston is all the way collapsed down here. So we're just gonna sit that up here right now. Keep it out of our way so it doesn't fall. And let's get the 17 millimeter and take this butt bracket off with the brake pads. Gotta lean on these a little. Get on the crack loose. Okay, now we're going to use our impact driver to take off the two bolts here. You got one here, it's a Phillips, and another one here. And you grab that and a hammer, and we'll knock these loose. And you hit it, and it cracks loose. Sometimes if you try and use like your DeWalt gun, you just strip these out. And this is a number two, real fat bit, Phillips to get them off. So we'll just unthread these. When we put them back on, we'll just put a little dab of number C's on the threads. And now the rotor should come right off. I want my caliper to fall, so I'm gonna try and find a happy medium spot for it here to rest. Okay, get that off. We got the new rotor. We're gonna put some never seize around the edge here, around here, and then we're gonna tighten the new rotor up. Let's get that on right now. You gotta line up the holes with the studs. Looks like this one here is going on like this. Okay, now the holes are lined up here, and we're just going to put a little dab of You can see these on our threads here. We've already cleaned up the rotor with a little bit of brake clean to get the oil film off of it from shipping packaging. We're just going to snug these up. You don't have to hit them again with the impact or the tightening. You can, but I wouldn't. Just get them snug like that. Okay, so that's all set there. Now, we're going to go and change our brake pads over, lube our slides and caliper pins. These things are kind of a pain in the butt to get out. We found to put the pads on. So we'll show you how we do it. You're taking the clips off. And we're going to wire brush everything with a little wire brush here. And then we're going to use our file and run it across to make sure everything's clean and flat. On like Chevy products, some of the larger truck manufacturers, these things to scale up, tend to scale up. And then they, when you try and put your brake pads on, you get a hard time because it's closing the distance down in between here and here. And then when you're trying to put your pad on, it's dragging, it's tight. So, as a habit, we will take a small file like this and we run it across the tops, just trying to get any rust off. These are pretty clean, but you want to see how you get some shiny metal there. So, we run it across the sides like this so that our clips fit down nice and even and the clips aren't being pushed up. When this stuff rusts and swells, it makes it, it gives you a real hard time trying to get your brake pads on. So we do that. We'll give it another quick wire brush. All right, this side's all set for clip. We're gonna do the same thing to this side. Run our file across it. Again. Okay, now we get our clips. You can set our clips in place. And the clips sit down nice and flush. You want to look to the sides to make sure that these lock down tight like that so that they're all flush. Do the same on these. See how those push down nice and tight? Now, the brake pads we found can be kind of a stinker to put on. We want to go over that. So we're going to put our brake caliper pin lube on this. If you try and put this on the car without the pads right now, it just breaks your ass trying to get these on. And then you force the clips and you slide the clips. You can damage the clips and you can push the clip into the rotor. And then it's going to give you a scraping noise. So we want to load this bracket with the brake pads now. And it's just going to make it easier to assemble. We've already got our new rotor on and tight and lubed. Now the last thing we got to do over here is pull our caliper pins out. And we have to get these all lubed as well. One of these has a rubber boot on it and the other one doesn't. The one with the rubber boot is usually harder to come out, which is that one. And we get the synthetic caliper pin grease. Put this on and don't be sparingly with it because whatever you push on is gonna end up inside this boot and it's just gonna help you out. So now this has the little rubber there. So we're gonna load this up with caliper pin grease. And to get this one started in there, you kinda gotta push it in. It's a little harder. It doesn't just fall right in. And the rubber's in there for a vibration issue that they would come out with. And if you can't get this to start in there, you can try and twisting it and then push it down in there. See how it's trying to push back? That's kind of what you want. There's a little air pocket in there right now that'll end up working its way out of it. But we want the caliper pins to move nice and easy, just like this. That's what you need to happen here. So now the shitty part, let's get the brake pads on and let me put a clean set of gloves on here. Trying not to get the brake pads dirty. And like I said, they come on and you gotta put them on an angle to get these things to go in there. And then try putting the bracket on the car and then putting the brake pads on, it's just fighting me very much. So let's start off here. And we've got our, well, we have brake pad with the clip. And we'll put that one on the outside. So if we have to try and check the brake. So I'm saying you gotta put them in on an angle like this to try and get these things to catch. And I'm pulling back on one of the tongues here, and it's, you're probably not gonna get it on the first shot. All right, so we got this one in, and we had it on an angle to force it down on an angle like this and pulled it up from the inside. Now, I'm gonna sand that paw print off of it. Now let's try and get this one in the same thing without knocking this one out. And it just won't let you roll it in like that. So you're gonna just keep, be patient with this and try and get it in. And the only way you can do it is getting it in on the, on an angle. So we got the bracket loaded up and we end up putting this thing in the vise and holding it in there. And you know, you put the pads in on an angle and then slide them back in place. It was a pain, I'm not gonna tell you it was easy. So, all right, so we got our two bolts here for the brackets. And slide this on and just make sure you don't knock your brake pads off as you're sliding it on. Just keep them squeezed. And line up the holes for the brackets here. Top one here. Okay. Make sure the brake pads didn't push out. They're good. Let's tighten these up. Last part of the job, I think, is getting the damn pads to set into the bracket. Okay, now we can put our caliper on. Make sure the hose doesn't get twisted. Our caliper piston is completely depressed. And okay, push the pin in here. Okay, now you got these both on. Yeah, you have a little nemesis on our bolts here. So let's put these in and try and catch them. Make sure you start these with your fingers. Sometimes you have to hold a 17 millimeter caliper pin because it spins like this one is. And you just put a wrench on the inside of it here to try and stop it. It's twisting the caliper on, it's kind of rolling it this way. So this caliper pin's not moving as of yet, so we don't have to put the wrench on this one. All right, that's tight, and we're going to just spray the rotor again and make sure there's no debris on the rotor. And we've got our slides lubricated with our clips. Like I said, you got to be careful because if you hammer these brake pads on, you're going to push this clip into the rotor and it's going to make this ungodly scraping noise. So you know, we put this in the vise to work it, to get the thing in there, and it took us a little bit of time to get that done, but that was the best way to do it. You want to make sure the pad slides evenly on the clips, you know, to make sure that it's not bound up. And that was all part of us filing the bracket down to make sure that happens. Everything's tight. I'm just going to double check, spray the rotor, and this brake job is finished. We'll pump up the brake pedal when we get in there so we have a firm brake, check our fluid level, and this is all set.